Here's Chris with another DIY tip for you.
Today's DIY tip, do-it-yourself tip from Low and Mean, is basically getting rid of the chrome. You know, sanding, primering, painting the chrome, and how do you do it? So it's pretty simple, actually, and it's a great cost-effective way to kind of give your starboard or your motorcycle a little personality. So we're gonna do it on the trim ring around the speedometer on this 2014 starboard. This item is pretty easy to remove. You really can get underneath it with your fingernails or get some sort of soft piece of plastic to pry it off of where it's at. You'll see there's no bolts, just a little bit of double-sided tape to remove this item. So let's go show you how we did this. So to do this, you definitely have to scuff up the chrome really good. You want to get in there, and what I have here is just a simple piece of Scotch Brite. You can get this at your local hardware store. But you want to scuff this up to the point where you're all the way down past the chrome and into where it starts getting brownish. Start seeing some of the copper popping through. You really want to get down to the copper and maybe a little bit through it to really get the primer to bite into the plastic. So I'm going to spend a little time on this, and I'll show you when I'm done and get to the next step. I'm starting to notice here that the more I sand this, the more that I'm taking off the shine, and it has a really cool satin, sort of anodized silver finish. And you know, some of you might have your own theme or whatever you want to do, and maybe just a Scotch-Brite of your chrome parts will give you that really cool look. Dropping chrome, son. Next step, once you have it all scuffed up and sanded well, is to do your primer surface. This is pretty important. This is the surface that's gonna really bite into it and give it that that paint, that durability that you're wanting. So definitely the more money you spend on a primer, the better quality you're gonna get, but you can't go for the 99 cent stuff if that's your program. So here we go. The smoother you put it on, the less you gotta sand. That's pretty much enough. We'll let that set, and then we'll come back and scuff it one more time before we hit it with our flat black. So now my primer is dried. I'm gonna pick it up and just scuff it up a little bit. Wanna scuff it one more time to get the flat black to stick to the primer really well. Just a light scuff and a white, and you're ready. We're using a very simple 99 cent can of flat black. It dries really fast and actually looks and works really well. All right, that'll dry in moments, and then we'll install it on the motorcycle so you can see the finished product. We have the speedometer ring painted. All you have to do is snap it back in place, make sure that the double-sided sticky tape sticks good, and there you go. That's pretty much it for this DIY. Now feel free to go around to the rest of the motorcycle where you see other chrome parts, like on the headlight or the tail light, and you can scuff, sand, primer, and paint them as well. And that's your DIY tip this week from Low and Mean.
Stay up to date on everything that's happening with this Bolt build by following us on Facebook. Yamaha Star Bolt is the page to look for. The forums are at www.yamahastarbolt.com. And of course, right here, subscribe to this YouTube channel. Go ahead, press the subscribe button. It's okay. And don't forget to check out lowandmean.com.